two different towns with an oasis in the desert to have fresh water. Again, Ein Gedi, have it. Here we have it. So, it's a blessing to have fresh water in the desert. There's a lot of people here, a lot of different rulers who wanted to conquer Jericho, who wanted to have the city of Jericho under their order. One people that you know of are Israelites. Israelites were sent here by Joshua, spies, Rahab, we talk about all that. So, all the Jericho, the Israelites crossing, and layers of civilization, and layers creep one upon another, right behind me. Then let me just share a small story about Elisha. Are you familiar with the prophet? That was Elisha. Elisha, first, and then Elisha. Elisha came to the city of Jericho, and he was cold, and the water are bad. He can't use them. He needs to see it. So he called the people of Jericho to give him a drink of salt. The water is depleted, and Jericho has fresh water to gain for the people of Israel. And it was a king. Yeah? So that's just one of the stories. Don't think that happened to the masses that they want to share about Jericho? Yeah? But for us to have this message here.
This is New Jericho. Original city. They say city of milk and honey. And then down there you see Old Jericho.
How do you call a place to make
oven?
Or but more like bricks. Kiln or clean?
Kiln.
To bake the brick. The muds and the mud bricks. And of course, it's soft and it's easier to destroy and then build on top and build on top. You know what's the tell? It's not a telephone, right?
It's layer to a city.
Tell is an archaeological mound. Everywhere in Israel we have tells. Tell this, tell this, tell that.
Yeah.
And the first tell you can call as the tell is Jericho. Tell Jericho, because this is the oldest and the first. Before tell Megiddo and tell this and tell that. It is an archaeological mound. It is civilizations one on top of another. And that's what creates a hill somehow. 7,000 or 8,000 years ago, probably people were living on lower grounds. They are on higher grounds later and later because of wars and invasions and destroying and rebuilding on top of each other. So they are more on a hill than in the lower ground.
Are they still working on this here? It doesn't look like anybody's here, so
needs a lot of money. It's under the Palestinian Authority today. It's the Ministry of Tourism, and they do.
There's a new dig by this guy, a man named Nikro. And he's just started last year. So it's new stuff.
Yeah, it lacks a lot of funding and all. But there is a lot of potential. I think there's a lot of potential.
Underneath.
To go down and but it really takes some time like this. By the way, the origin of the spring, if you look down, you'll see these bricks, the red bricks. This is where the spring stood. This is the original source of the water. There are pipes that are pumping water over to the other side where we stood. So there's a huge pumping station here, right underneath. And that's where the water is pumped to the houses of Jericho today, where it spreads out in the Jordan Valley. This is the Jordan Valley, right? So if you go down south where we came from, that's where the Dead Sea is. If you go up north, you follow the Jordan River. The Jordan River is going down from the north down to the Dead Sea. The baptism, John the Baptist, spent a lot of time in these areas, in these places here, baptizing people. Jesus withdrew himself to the mountains. Where? The place where he was tempted. The Mount of Temptation. Looking over on the other side, we're looking at the Mount of Temptation. There is a monastery actually that's been added in the middle of it called the one called 40 days before he had to be fasted. And that is another biblical site, of course, believed to be the place where the devil can't be used to jump down all the kingdoms.
See, that's the same one that...
Yes, there's a little cable car that's going. On the left of it, there's like a building, like a line.
Yeah,
that's a church. It's a monastery. It's a Greek Orthodox monastery. Yeah, it's been built there.
The holes in the rock represent the monastery.
Where's that? The halls, there's actually caves. Caves. People are living in caves. Believe that Jesus spent time in a big cave, and that cave is where that monastery is built today. Okay.
Is that a mosque over there?
Yes, the ones with the green you see and some minarets, they would be mosques around this area. There's
good
less
picture.
Impressive
monastery.
Finds here today as palaces, as Masada,
sorry,
as other places
hands
to call.
It's been a long day. My hands are tired.
The city of Jericho,
try it again.
Then real structures are standing. So there's mud more, there's the bricks over there. So rather than go really that far out there, you can explore a little bit 5 minutes and on. And others would like to share things here, to read us from the Bible.
It's the Hill of Temptations.
We're happy to hear from
Mount
you guys.
Of Temptation.
But you are here in the ancient city of Jericho.
Look at the stairs there.
I didn't even have it on. Alright, that's the original structure from the original city, Jericho. Destroyed because of all wars and fights and everything. This poor country's been there. There's a sign there. Says, but it's cool. Ah, beautiful day. Flies are bad, I can't hold still, sorry.
Jericho, Jericho, Joshua fit the battle of early in the morning, that's when the trumpets blew. They marched around the city at the Battle of Jericho. Jehoshaphat, the Battle of Jericho, Jericho, Jericho. Jehoshaphat, the Battle of Jericho, and the walls come to tumbling down. Jehoshaphat, the Battle of Jericho, Jericho, Jericho. Jehoshaphat, the Battle of Jericho, and the walls come tumbling down. Right up to the walls of Jericho, he marched with spear in hand. Joshua commanded the children to shout, and the walls come a-tumbling down.